الله الرحمن الرحيم. نويت الأربعين، نويت الاعتكاف، نويت الخلوة، نويت العزة، نويت الرياء، نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. أطيع الله وأطيع الرسول وولي الأمر منكم. Tonight we continue explaining inshallah سورة الكهف verse from verse 26 to 33. سورة مريم sorry سورة مريم from verse 26 to 33. شيخ صاحب محمود will recite inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فكلي واشربي وقري عينا فإما ترين من البشر أحدا فقولي إني نذرت للرحمن صوما فلن أكلم اليوم إنسيا فأتت به قومها تحمله قالوا يا مريم لقد جئت شيئا فريا يا أخت هارون ما كان أبوك امرأ سوء وما كانت أمك بغيا فأشارت إليه قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبيا قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا وبرا بوالدتي ولم يجعلني جبارا شقيا والسلام علي يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حيا صدق الله العظيم.
صدق الله العظيم وبلغ رسوله الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين الشاكرين بقلب سليم. So we said that فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا and so eat and drink and cool thine eye. When Virgin Mary came, she want to deliver, and she came to the trunk of the tree of the date, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give life to that tree from being dry to live another time and give fruit. So she was hungry. So what? She heard a voice from under her knee, under her, that Allah has made under you a rivulet. Grieve not, for thy Lord has provided a rivulet beneath thee. And we explained that last time. And then the sound continues saying, and shake toward thyself the trunk of the palm tree. It will let fall fresh ripe dates upon thee. We explained that also. But what we did not explain is that from that verse, the order came to her to shake the tree. Shaking is an action, physical action. So she needed a physical action to shake the tree. For water, that's what it is said, that water, you run for it. It doesn't come to you. Drink water, you have to go after it. water doesn't run, doesn't come to you, because Allah gave it. So you have to, He will provide it for you. So you have to go, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send it to you. It will reach you wherever you are, even you are far. For water, water will come to you. Food doesn't come to you. So we have to correct here. Water, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't need to run after your water, because it is the fountain of life, the youth, fountain of youth, the life. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. We have made from water everything alive. So water comes to you. Allah will send it to you. Wherever you are, you will get the water. You don't need to run after water, because water is the source of life. Food, you have to run after it. Food, you have to run after your food. You have to go look for it, search for it. It will not come to you. Only comes to pious people like Virgin Mary when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending to her food in her niche, but not to everyone. But water, anyone can take free. You go anywhere, you take water, no one will charge you money even for your, for the water you are drinking. But for food, they say, yeah, pay. Right? Because Allah made the water a necessity. So it has to reach you without effort. But food needs effort. That's why he told her, shake the tree. He didn't tell her, shake the river that we made under you. Because Jibreel alayhi salam hit the ground after her, under her came water. But he didn't hit the ground and let the date comes. So it needed an action from her to move the tree, shake it. Then what will happen? The date will come. He said, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِزْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا. And shake toward thyself the trunk of the palm tree. It will let fall fresh ripe dates upon thee. وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ. And shake what? Toward what? Toward you. Toward thyself. He didn't say shake the tree. Of course, you shake the tree, it's coming now. He said, shake toward yourself. Means to us a message. That, as we said before, that Virgin Mary represent what? We said
purity.
So purity represent Virgin Mary. Any purity means the symbol of Maryamiya. The Maryam symbol is purity. So if you have a pure heart, we say you have a Maryami heart. A qalbun Maryamiyun. A Maryami heart means a pure heart. So when you have a pure heart, then shake that heart toward the inner self, because he said, shake the tree toward thyself. So shake that heart that you have toward the inner self, throwing away impurity, you will be receiving visions and inspiration to your heart. There will be no veils. As she received, what she received at that moment through Jibreel alayhi salam, anyone who will imitate the purity of Virgin Mary, he will achieve that level. So the heart is the Al-Qalb al-Maryami, is the purity of the heart. You have to shake it with what? Toward the inner self. What is the tree? It is said the palm tree is symbolized, show you كلمة التوحيد لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. When you shake the heart by كلمة التوحيد and there and reach a level of purity of oneness for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing in your heart except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through recitation of كلمة التوحيد لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, through that كلمة, what will happen? Fruit, as the date tree, when she shake the date tree, fruit came down. When you shake your heart with كلمة التوحيد, with ذكرullah, what will happen? Fruit of the blessed, beautiful 99 names and attributes will be bestowing on you تجلي, that تجلي of جلال and جمال and mercy. With that heart that you are trying to shake, as she shaked, because the date tree was dry. The date tree was dry. Because of her purity in her heart, Allah make that date tree alive. And to show her a sign, don't think it's too much. As we gave you a son without a father, the date tree doesn't need, what's that?
Fertilizing,
mating. Ta'bir in Arabic we say, no father. It gives fruit without needs a, not fertilizing, what there is something.
Pollination.
That you bring from one female tree to one male tree, put them together. No, day tree doesn't need that. Make it live. Allah make it, that day tree has life. We make. So you shake, the fruit came to you. Shake the pure heart with kalimatul tawheed. That is what shuyukh knew, that secret. And that's why they call it al-qalb al-maryami, the Maryam heart, the symbol of Maryam heart. When they found that through that heart, the purity of that heart can receive tajalli, the blessings and the manifestation of the 99 names, beautiful names, through kalimatul tawheed, that's why they produced or they brought that way of zikrullah through hidden zikr, silent zikr and jahri zikr. Because silent zikr, because he told her, shake it toward thyself. Means to the inner self. You have to inform the inner self, not the physical only. When we say La ilaha illallah jahri, we are telling to our forum. When we say it silently, we are telling to our inner self. That is the most important. And that's why Naqshbandi zikr, always silent zikr. And what we are doing in these circles and associations is imitating the other 40 tariqat in their loud zikr. But for Naqshbandis, it is hidden. When you do your own zikr, Allah, Allah, it must be hidden, silent. تضرعاً وخيفةً ودون الجهر من القول. Keep silent. So that's why he said in the Holy Quran, وَهُزِّ إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ وَهُزِّ إِلَيْكِ toward yourself. toward the inner self. Tell your inner heart, not only the physical heart that everyone can see, shaitan can enter there. Everyone knows what you are from your personality, what you are. No, you have to achieve purity in the inner heart, inside. That's what it is, the importance. Not you go and you do things to show off. That Allah knows is not acceptable. But he said, وَهُزِّ إِلَيْكِ, shake toward you, toward the inner self. So awliya, saints, knew that reality. So through the state of ihsan, they went so high in producing and in recitation of La ilaha illallah through their heart to declare the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to their inner self. And that's why Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَخْوَفُ مَا أَخَافُ عَلَى أُمَّتِي أَشْرِكُ الْخَفِي. The most fear I feel for my ummah is the hidden shirk, because the inside shirk that you cannot see, not through the tongue, but through the heart inside. That's why he said, shake it toward yourself. When you manifest, you get these manifestations of the tajalli, of the blessings of the 99 beautiful names and attributes, you will be dressed the dress of manhood. You will be dressed the dress of manhood. You will achieve the level of ar-rijal, manhood. We are not, look, don't say that, oh, we are men, we achieve that. No. Men and women not yet achieving manhood. When you reach manhood, means you reach the level of sainthood. That's what it meant. Until you reach the level of manhood, of sainthood, you will be reaching the manhood, to be a man. From woman and men. That's why Rabi al-Adawiya was a saint. She reached the level of man. Maryam, Sayyida Maryam, Virgin Mary, reached that level. And that's why she, from whole Quran, she is only mentioned by name. She is the only woman mentioned by name. As prophets are being mentioned by name, and we explained that before.
Allah, Allah. فأتت به قومها تحمله. Now, before prophets, she came to her. Before we arrive that here, I like to mention that when you achieve the level of manhood, that is one of the highest level that you reach. And what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said in his hadith, أَبِيتُ عِنْدَ رَبِّي يُطْعِمُنِي وَيُسْكِنِي.
Understood? أَبِيتُ, understood? أَبِيتُ عِنْدَ رَبِّي يُطْعِمُنِي وَيُسْكِنِي. Means, أَبِيت means, for example, I go to you, visiting you, what I say? بِتُ عِنْدَك, I stayed the overnight, I spent the overnight with you. That's what was that in English?
I spent
my time in your place. So what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I used to spend my time in his divine presence. He will feed me and he will quench my thirst. يطعمني أبيت عند ربي يسقيني يطعمني ويسقيني. Feed me and quench my thirst. Means I don't need food, and I need his love. His love is the source of energy for me. فكلي واشربي وقري عينا. فإما ترين من البشر أحدا فقولي إني نذرت للرحمن صوما فلن أكلم اليوم إنسيا. So eat and drink and cool thine eye, and if thou dost see any man say, I have vowed a fast to Allah, most gracious, and this day will I enter into no talk with any human being. She gave a vow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that she will not speak. So, eat and drink. And if someone asks you, eat from this river, drink from this river and eat from the food, or in the interpretation, you are in the, his divine presence, he will bless you with the fountain of youth, with that divine tajalli, that is will be your food and your drink. As Prophet ﷺ said, I stay overnight, means I stay in his, I come to his presence, and Allah will feed me and quench my thirst. That's وَفَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي وَقَرِّ عَيْنًا. So eat and drink and cool thine eye, because that food is a heavenly food, because he made the tree to from dry tree to a living tree, from no water to a river under her. So it is a heavenly, miraculous power. So Allah gave it to her, and that's why it is proved by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam hadith that when I go to the divine presence, in my presence of my Lord, he will feed me and he will quench my thirst with that tajalli, with that energy. So when she ate and finished, he said, if you see anyone, man or woman, and they ask you, say, I am not going to speak. I gave an oath that I will not speak. At that time, فَإِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا. إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا. I have made an oath that I will not صَوْم, fasting. Fasting of what? Not of food. إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا. I have vowed a fast to Allah, most gracious. What's that fast? Huh? What was that fast to you before?
Not to speak.
So will I enter into talk? I will not speak, because in that time before Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they had a tradition at that time. Their culture is to, when they have a problem, they don't speak, or if they have a situation, they stop speaking. And that was in time of Prophet prohibited anymore. In Islam, no more. It's not allowed to keep quiet. For such issues, you have to speak.
Huh. Allah, Allah. The Siyam, the pious people in the time of Bani Israel, people of Israel, the pious people at that time used to stop from food, fasting from food and fasting from speaking. And that's what happened, the sign for Zakaria when he went from his mihrab, and Allah gave him a sign for the pregnancy of his wife, was what? He was not able to speak. That was the tradition there. And for this ummah, the ummah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it has been forbidden. It is said that silence, not fasting on speech, you can speak, there is no fasting on speech in Islam, but silence, to keep silence, is sifatul rijal. To keep quiet, not to silent, is the sifa, what sifa?
Quality.
Is the quality of manhood. Although to speak, not to keep silent, in its place, it's an honorable level. Means when you speak, when it is necessary to speak, it's a good situation. When you keep quiet in a place where you don't need to speak, is quality of manhood. What is forbidden in Islam is the complete fasting from talking. So it is said that silence, not to go into communications of speeches with people, في ما لا يعني, wasting your time in something that has no value, no importance, is recommended. And with that, you keep your heart rejuvenated with zikrullah. And awliya always, they are silent except when it's necessary to speak, and their heart is always in complete zikr, is not silent. The heart is not silent, speaking with their Lord, calling his oneness and calling upon him and declaring the oneness of Allah through their heart, by la ilaha illallah through their heart, and keeping their tongue quiet. What he said in Holy Quran said, say, فَقُولِ إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ سَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَا يَوْمَ أَنْسِيَا. I'm not going to speak with anyone. Will I enter, and this day will I enter into no talk with any human being. Because Allah told her through that voice not to speak with anyone, because whatever she is going to say, they are not going to believe. Because man has, the people has suspicion. Is not? People, what they have? They are suspicious of everything. You say, no, I didn't do that. They say, no, you did that. Is not? So Allah, to clear her, he didn't want anyone to speak, even he didn't want her to speak. But he want Sayyidina Isa, her son, to speak. Because when he speaks, when he is young, that is miracle to stop them to be suspicious for what she did. Like Sayyidina Aisha, radiallahu anha wa ardaha, Allah sent her bara'a, innocence, from what people had in their minds. Although she is wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and people were suspicious. So what do you think about yourself and ourselves this time? Everyone going to be suspicious of everyone. Shaitan is playing with everyone. Husnuzan, no more. Husnuzan, what's husnuzan?
Keeping good opinion.
Keeping good opinion, good thoughts of some people, don't be suspicious. It's no more. Suspicious, it must be there to be suspicious. Oh, very good. Shaitan give you credit for it. So Allah told her, no. Say, I gave oath not to talk to anyone. Allah will send my innocence.
فأتت به قومها تحمله.
فأتت به قومها تحمله. At length she brought the baby to her people. Ibn Abbas said that she left when sunrise was coming up, sun was rising, and she came noon with the child to her people. So Zakaria didn't find her in her niche. He was worried. He sent her uncle's son, Joseph,
Yusuf because he used to secure her and protect her at her door. He went to look for her. He found her under the palm tree. When she came back with him to her uncle home, Zachariah, and they were very pious, they began to cry. And they told her, قالوا يا مريم لقد جئت شيئا فريا. Carrying him in her arms, they said, oh Mary, يا مريم. They are what you say, موبخ, when you shout and huh?
Accusing?
No, not accusing. Blame. Not blame. Oh Mary, truly a strange thing has thou brought. It's tawbih is when you someone did something wrong and he feel embarrassed what you say when someone shouted.
Scolded
him. That's not scolding with anger, but scolding was saying, what's this? What these things that you made? Yeah. What you did something so strange, we cannot understand it. يا أخت هارون, O sister of Aaron, thy father was not a man of evil, nor thy mother a woman unchaste. يا أخت هارون, ما كان أبوك امرأ سوء وما كانت أمك بغية. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it is said in hadith that she was related to Harun alayhi salam, and between her and Harun was 1,800 years. When the Quran mentioned Ya Ukhta Harun, he traced her Quran. He traced her genealogy, lineage back to Harun alayhi salam. That she is from that line. In one word, Ya Ukhta Harun. It's enough. The sister of Harun, from that lineage. She is coming from that lineage. And it is said Harun is her brother from her father. And it is said that Harun also, who is the brother of Musa alayhi salam. ما كان أبوك امرأ سوء. Thy father was not a man of evil. Her father was whom? Was Imran. Imran was not a bad person. Nor thy mother a woman unchaste. وما كانت أمك حنة بن فاقوذ. You remember we mentioned her name. The mother was حنة بن فاقوذ. Ibn Abbas said, Imran, her father were never made adultery. وما كانت أمك بغية حنة بن فاقوذ. She was never had adultery before. So how you brought this child without a husband? It is said in تفسير روح البيان that وَاعْلَمْ أَنَّ الْمُعْتَادِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الزَّمَانِ إِذَا أَظْهَرَ اللَّهُ فِي كُلِّ زَمَانٍ نَبِيًّا أَوَّلِيًّا يخصه بمعجزة أو كرامة أن ينكر عليه أكثرهم. It is said that traditionally in this through this life, I said before, that people are suspicious. No one believe anything. So it is said that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought a messenger or a prophet until the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was the seals of Prophet, and Allah also sent awliya, pious people, and for prophets he gave them miracles, for awliya he gave them karama. Many people come and accuse them that they are foolish
and they are on deviating from the right track. Look, Abu Jahl, how much he came against Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Look, Awliya, how much people are coming against them, accusing them of evil things, deviating from the right path of Islam. So it is something naturally in our life. That is how it is molded in the heart of people to be suspicious of everything. And that's why Allah said, إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَأٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا أَنْ تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ فَتُصْبِحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ. Something, if someone came with a message, wrong information, check it before you fall into accusation, accusing people of wrongdoings. So when she brought the child, immediately what they did? They accused her. Why didn't wait? Allah is telling us, wait. What they said? As soon as she said, at length she brought the baby to her people, carrying him in her arms, they didn't say anything. Wait. Listen. Might be someone gave her a baby. Listen. Might be she found it. What they said? Oh, Mary, truly a strange thing has thou brought. O sister of Aaron, thy father was not a man of evil. Why? Accusing immediately. Nor thy mother a woman unchaste. It is that in the husnul zan, in the good thinking, good to give good thought about something and not to be suspicious. If someone, a pious person, through his piety, went into his path, seeking his way to his Lord, leaving the whole community of scholars, becoming ascetic, go into the way of seekers, and come back from his long way that he went seeking knowledge, and came back with something that might be strange to you, don't throw it on him as if it doesn't exist, but give him a time and keep good thinking about him, and don't accuse him of being a bad person creating things from himself. So what she did now, when they told her that, فأشارت إليه. قالوا كيف نكلمه من كان في المهدي صبيا. But she pointed to the baby. They said, how can we talk to one who is a child in the cradle? She didn't talk. She's keeping quiet. قالوا كيف نكلمه من كان في المهدي صبيا. How we can speak with someone who is in the cradle? How they understood that she is telling them to, she is pointing and making the sign that he is going to speak. Yeah? How they knew? You carry a baby and come and you make like that. What's that? How they knew that she is telling them that? قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهدي. How we can speak to a baby in his cradle? She didn't tell him that you are going to speak with the baby. She might be she's telling them, look at him. Allah threw in their hearts fear. When she pointed, that is a sign of miraculous power. When you point, with that shahada finger, that sababa. One Sayyidina, that big story, but not we are not going to come to it. Awliya, when the finger for tawheed, is not? What you call this finger?
Index
finger, that's for tawheed. When she raised her finger, shaking their hearts now. Awliya, when they move their fingers, that index finger to the heart of their murid, they open 6 powers to them. حقيقة الجذب، حقيقة الفيض، حقيقة التوجه، حقيقة التوسل، حقيقة الطي، حقيقة الإرشاد، حقيقة الجذب. 6 powers to their hearts. When they raise inheriting that secret from prophets, Allah gave them that inheritance. And when they achieved the high level of purity, becoming their heart, Maryami heart, they use the finger. قلب المريمي, who reached the heart of Virgin Mary from Awliya, from sainthood, who reached that level, if he move his finger, it will shake hearts of people with tawheed. That's why how they converted masses in India and Pakistan. How Islam spread with no language. They didn't know Urdu, Sahaba. They didn't know Chinese. They didn't know Uzbeki language. They didn't know Pashto. They didn't know Kashmiri language. What kind of language they had? Many language. How? They converted masses. By moving their hearts toward Tawheed. When they achieved the heart of Maryami heart, the heart of Virgin Mary, then they can, فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ, they can have this power. But she pointed to the baby. To the baby, she pointed with the finger, index. When she pointed, everything changed. They knew the child is going to speak. Because they said, how we are going to speak with him? He is in the cradle. They knew he is going to answer them. What he said? Huh? What first word said? Inni Abdullah. Don't think I am son of God or God. Oneness. He gave the oneness, Tawheed. So when she pointed to him with the finger of Tawheed, he spoke with Tawheed. Say, I am the son, I am the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See the sequence of the words behind each other? فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ, when she pointed to him, they said, how are you going to speak with him? They knew he's going to speak. And in order that when she moved her finger of Tawheed, she moved their hearts to accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So first word to them, because he knew at the end they are going to be unbelievers to say that he is son of God. He said, no, I am slave of Allah, Tawheed. I am servant. Inni Abdullah. قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا. He said, I am indeed a servant of Allah. He has given me revelation and made me a prophet. قال إني عبد الله, in a pure language. He admitted on himself the state of عبودية. Means the state, he admitted that he is servant and Allah the creator. When he said, I am the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am not the son of Allah, to tell them that don't say that in future, I am son of Allah. I am servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when he spoke, he immediately threw the suspicion from his mother to her that she made adultery, he gave her innocence. So Tawheed give innocence from hellfire.
قال الجنيد لست بعبد سوء. I am not a servant, bad servant. ولا عبد طمع. I am not a greedy servant. ولا عبد شهوة. I am not a servant for desires. Means he is showing the best of the names is Abd.
It is an honor for everyone to be called Abd.
And the best name is what? Abdullah. Then Abdul Rahman. Then Abdul Rahim. Then Abdul Karim. Then Abdul Hay, Abdul Haq. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the best names are Abdullah, Abdul Hay, Abdul Haq is the highest, because Abdul Haq, Abdul Hay and Abdullah are the attribute of the essence. Allah is the attribute for the essence, Hay is the essence, Haq is the essence. And that's why Ibn Taymiyyah and this Salafi ideology of today, they say don't make zikr with Allah, with Haq and Hay. You know that? That's what they say. Because it relates to the essence. And we like to do zikr with Allah, Haq and Hay, because it is for the essence.
Allah Akbar.
And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best are Abdullah, Abdul Hay, Abdul Haq. What? أخرج ابن أبي حاتم narrated, he rewrote in his book Abi Hatim from Malik, that he said, according to Suyuti, that Sayyidina Isa, when his mother was pregnant in him, and Zakaria, his mother, pregnant in him, and when they met at that small period of time, the mother of Yahya said to Maryam, "Inni ara ma fi batni yasjudu lima fi batni." I am seeing what is in my womb making sajda to the one of in your womb. Means Yahya is making in my womb making sajda when they met to the one in your womb. قال مالك, he said, مالك said, أرى ذلك لتفضيل الله عيسى. Allah, because that is a sajda, not of sajda of worshipness, but sajda of respect, honoring Isa, because Isa, Allah gave him the power to rejuvenate death. And pure al-akmaha wal-abrasa. What's akmah abras in English? Those who have
leprosy.
He used to cure them, and it's difficult to cure them. So Allah gave him higher level from Yahya alayhi salam. Sayyidina Isa. Allah, Allah. It is said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given four boys from his generosity something big. وقد أكرم الله تعالى أربعة من الصبيان بأربعة أشياء. Allah gave these four prophets four big issues. Yusuf, he gave him revelation in the well. وعيسى gave him to speak in the cradle. And Sulaiman, he gave him mind. And Yahya, he gave him wisdom. But the biggest and the most valuable, honored, precious, huge power that has been given is to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He gave him prostration the day of birth. When he came from the womb of his mother, he went into the position of prostration. And he made him messenger from that moment, Rasulullah wa Khatam al-Rusul. And he cleaned his heart and he gave him the seal of Nubuwa, the seal of prophecy on his shoulder. And he made angels for his service. And he brought the Hur al-Ain from heavens for his birth. And he was given prophecy in the day of promises. Before he was the prophet and he was the light before anyone been created, and all prophets were his followers. It is an honor for us to be from the Ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا. He said, I am indeed a servant of Allah. He has given me revelation and made me a prophet. آتاني الكتاب, he gave me revelation of the Bible, Injil. وجعلني نبيا, he made me prophet. وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا. And he has made me blessed wheresoever I be, and had enjoined on me prayer and zakat as long as I live. He made me honorable, blessed. He gave me the Bible when I was child. He gave me the mind of men when I was child. أينما كنت, wherever I was, that was following with me. وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة, and he recommended, how they translated, and has enjoined on me prayer and zakat as long as I live. He asked me to give zakat and to make prayers, whatever, as long as I live. So still he is living, so still he's paying zakat and making prayers in paradise, because Allah raised him, as we explained last time. Allah raised him to heaven. Why? We didn't explain that before. Why? You remember? No. Why?
Because we were in heaven before. We came here to die. So he came here first, so he has to go there and come here.
Allahu Akbar. ما دمت حيا, as I live, I have to pay zakat and salah. Means we have to pray and give zakat as long as we live. Don't believe of these people of today. They say, nope, don't pray. Only make zikr. Only have good heart. No. وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيَّ. He ordered me with salah and zakah as long as I live. Means obligation is obligation. And these people who are putting in the mind
these Salafis, Wahhabis, are putting in the mind of normal Muslims that Ahl al-Tasawwuf, the people of Ihsan, they don't pray. That is a lie. They're planting in their mind suspicion. Look, he said, no, as long as you live, you have to pray and you have to pay zakat, you have to fast, you have to do what you have to do as Allah gave us the obligation through Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَبَرَّمْ بِوَالِدَتِي وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا. He has made me kind to my mother and not overbearing or unblessed. He made me to be good with her, soft with her, and he didn't made me hard-hearted, arrogant, like today. Children with their parents are arrogant. They don't like to speak with them. They say, what they understand, we know better. No, you have to be patient. You have to be soft. وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا. He didn't make me arrogant against his disobeying him. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيَّا. For Yahya, he said, وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْهِ, in the past tense, blessings on him, in the past tense. In Isa, he said, وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ, peace on me, in present tense. What is the difference? What is the important about it? Why Sayyidina Isa praising his birthday, saying, the day I was born, and Yahya praising, Allah praising his birthday, we will keep it for next time. And why we have to praise the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam birthday and make the comparison, we will leave it for next time, inshallah. Wa min Allahi at-tawfiq bi hurmati al-Fatiha. Understood? Or not? Huh? What you are saying? Yes. Mm-hmm.